What's going on, guys? It's Jesse here with NAVAC, and I'm here today to talk to you about an inexpensive way to make sure that you're protecting your investment, aka your recovery machine. Let's go ahead and get into it.
Here's the reality of the situation at hand. At some point in your career, you're bound to come across a compressor that has had a burnout, so that we know that the refrigerant inside of this system has an acidic value or is contaminated. Now, we don't want to damage our recovery equipment, but this refrigerant still has to be recovered.
Can you tell me a little bit what's going on there? That don't look very safe.
Yeah, that's that, just hold on. Yeah, don't worry about that. We'll just keep it here.
So, when we talk about the filter dryer, we are not cleaning the refrigerant. All we're doing is protecting our investment. By pulling the contaminated refrigerant through this filter dryer, we are helping to ensure that our recovery machine does not get damaged by the acidic or contaminated refrigerant inside of the system. Again, insanely affordable insurance policy for a huge investment for you or your company.
You have a few different options when it comes to actually attaching the filter dryer, but regardless of what you choose, pay attention if you're not using a bi-flow or multi-flow filter dryer to the orientation. In this particular example, we have a female end that is going to thread directly onto the recovery machine's inlet. Now, once we've actually attached this, we can look to go ahead and attach our rapid Y fitting, which will take a 1/4-inch service port and turn it into 2 3/8 service ports attached to the filter dryer directly to help prevent any sort of damage or contaminants entering our recovery machine. Well, let's say that you can't find that female thread filter dryer. You can use a little hose just like this one to achieve the same results. So all you're going to do is attach the hose, go ahead and grab your male-to-male filter dryer, attach it, make sure you're paying attention to the orientation of the filter dryer. And once it's attached, then you're going to take our rapid Y fitting and you're going to go ahead and attach the 1/4-inch side to the filter dryer itself, which again will allow us to recover using 2 3/8 larger diameter hoses during the recovery process. Now let's say you want to step it up a notch. You want to maintain the same diameter throughout the entire recovery process. You can do so by adding an adapter to the recovery machine itself. Now in addition to this, we're going to take this adapter and we're going to use this additional adapter to make sure that we can fit this male-to-male 3/8 filter dryer. Then we simply attach our filter dryer to the adapter itself and we're ready to go ahead and attach our rapid Y. Now this rapid Y has 3/8 to 3/8 to 3/8, so there's no 1/4-inch adapter on this rapid Y, but this allows us to maintain a larger diameter during the recovery process.
Doing something as simple as including a filter dryer in line for your recovery process will help protect your investment. Guys, this has been Jesse with NAVAC. I hope you got something out of this. We'll see you around.